Hey, Michael Church, Crawl Space Ninja and Basement Ninja. I recently had the opportunity to sit down with Corey Spohn of Hydraway, and I asked him to explain what exactly is hydrostatic pressure and why is it important for you to know what it is and how it works.
So hydrostatic pressure is, in my time working with Hydraway, I've seen the term thrown around so much. It's almost like I wonder if those that use the terminology really know what it means. If you're familiar with water in an ice cube, if you put water in a tray and they put it into the freezer, it'll expand. If you put a pop or something in the freezer, it'll blow up. Soils act the same way when they're exposed to water. The soils are simple. They're either made up with a lot of organic material or they're not. The more organic material they have in them, the more they're like a sponge and they soak up. If you trap that soil, when I say trap it, like you don't allow it to expand, so in essence to contain it, it will push. And when it pushes, that's basically a good layman's way to explain hydrostatic pressure. So in a foundation, in homes, what we see a lot is we get a lot of introduction of water from the outside. So water's building up, it's collecting from a valley, a swell, improper grading, running down the foundation. It might build up in that soil for a few days before it starts to really push on the exterior walls or push from the basement floor up. So what happens is that's the pressure that we're referring to. And that's why it's important that contractors and homeowners understand how you control hydrostatic pressure, and you have to allow it a way to release. In essence, it's almost breathing. When you have a basement, and let's say from the outside or underneath, two of the most common areas I see hydrostatic pressure are the soils on the outside of the foundation. So they've got wet, they've expanded, they're pushing pressure now on our block or our poured wall. Or below, water's gathered, and now we've trapped it. If I can do the best with my fingers, we've got a basement floor and our stem walls and our footer. Now we've kind of caught it in that pocket, and it's expanded and pushing up. We've got natural exposed areas where water will seep through our basement and our cove joint or on top of the footer. It's pushing. The water has nowhere to go. The soil that is supposedly won't perk is perking water somehow up through it. With hydrostatic pressure, we just want to catch it and we want to gather it and we want to allow a way to get out. When the term's thrown around, I think the key to ask back or to understand the solution is how do you relieve that hydrostatic pressure? With our system, we relieve it with a lot of open area, allowing that to push up against it. You can do it with aggregate or without aggregate. One will relieve it a little faster than the other, but that's what the contract should be explaining to the homeowner or the DIY person should understand, is you're trying to relieve that pressure. It's going to keep reoccurring. It's an over and over thing. You can't remove the soils. The soils will keep expanding and contracting as the seasons change and water is introduced.